Manchester, the home of Oasis, the industrial era, and the invention of the computer. Manchester has a rich and vibrant cultural history, and one of its newest cultural phenomenons is street art. Very superstitious. Fifty Shades of Graffiti, dominating the city and overpowering the streets with its colour and charisma. But is it simply contaminating our streets like a rampant Russian nerve agent? Or has it brought healing to the city targeted by tragedy? What does street art mean to Manchester? Graffiti, meaning scribbling on a flat surface, originated from the Italian word scrofario, and has existed since 1967, when a Philadelphia teenager wrote across the city's walls in order to land himself a date. After this, graffiti wasn't accepted as a form of art until the 1980s, and is now known to everyone on the planet. So, why is graffiti stereotyped as bad? For starters, it's illegal without permission of the property owner, and can lead to imprisonment and fines. This means that most street art is stumbled upon and found in quieter areas, which means its audience can often be smaller than conventional art. But although some think of graffiti as art, a lot of people see it as a nuisance, associating it with gang and antisocial behaviour. The cost of cleaning up this art craze starting at a whopping £1 billion in the UK alone. Although on the other hand, street art can be made highly profitable, taking its place among the mainstream media, including music videos, fashion and advertisement. So what is the difference between graffiti and street art? Let's see if the public can decide.
So I like street art that uses words in a funny way, mixed with pictures. I've just come back from Amsterdam, and everywhere there is art everywhere you look.
I think, you know, street art and art in general is a great way of expressing, you know, certain things that words might not be able to. And yeah, with street art, it brings the community as a whole together, rather than just like a bit of art on a bit of paper that you keep yourself.
Graffiti and street art are two commonly confused terms. Graffiti often selects its audience, being harder to understand, whereas street art has a larger emotional response throughout the community. To delve deeper into this, we talked to Tasha Whithall, a prominent street artist in the Manchester area.
My project, what I do, I'm a curator, so that's like a completely different discipline within itself, but I am also an artist. I work with illustration and I'm quite a visual work, but I'm also working in sound as well. I like to create site-specific installations. You know, I definitely wouldn't call myself a graffiti artist. I wouldn't really call myself a street artist either. I'm a multidisciplinary artist.
So, do you think that street art can have a larger impact on the general public than art could have in a museum?
Yeah, definitely. Just because of your public audience that's there. If you put work in the street, anybody will see it. But if you put work in a museum, there's only going to be a specific clientele that are going to go there and or people that are interested in it. Whereas if you're in the street, you kind of have no... You're just going to see it. You have no choice. Mm-hmm. You are going to walk or stumble upon it.
Yeah. So you've been part of the Outhouse Project. Could you just tell us how that kind of came about?
I founded the Outhouse Project in 2011. It was based off just somebody saying, would you like to paint the square? And I went, yeah. And that's how the project started. It's just been a real... organic process into what's happened there.
So, what does street art mean to us? Is it an eyesore? Is it offensive? Or has it brought a form of healing and brought this community closer?
What I really like about street art, especially in Manchester, it can bring a real sense of vibrancy to the whole place, especially if you look around the Northern Quarter. It brings a real sort of community feel because people can put like messages on there, or especially with the bees, especially with the bees and stuff like that.
Jay's wife and daughter were at the arena at the actual time. I got a call the next day and he was like, right, we're painting, and that's all I knew. And it's like, we're going to go to Fred Arliss to get our paint, and we're just going to paint. We're painting. We got a crew of people together, and someone else, another artist was out of town, and he was just up there, and we just painted. It's like, it was just as simple as that. There was no, we just did it. It was more of like, right, we've got to do something.
After the Manchester terror attacks of May 22nd, 2017, did our view of street art change completely? The Manchester Bee has become more than a symbol. It's the unity of Manchester people. It's a determination and hope to overcome. And street art has evolved and adapted to these situations. It's become an integral part of our community. And no one can see where street art is going next, or how it's even going to change. But one thing's for sure, it's always going to be there.